So yesterday I did a video that is titled "The Tide is Turning Against Ben Shapiro." And basically what that video was is a video that was an analysis of what's going on with Ben Shapiro currently speaking in terms of like the political sphere and the social sphere. And I was explaining to you guys that, wow, ever since his interview with Andrew Neil from the BBC, where he rage quit the interview and had, you know, stooped down to some pretty darn childish tactics, like, for example, saying that, you know, he's popular and that no one's heard of Andrew Neil. And that was a really big debacle, to the point where he had to concede that he did wrong, as well as his fans had to do that as well. That, and then a combination of that with people re-bringing up his comment about how people whose homes are going to be underwater should just sell their underwater homes and move in order to not be affected by climate change, and easy peasy, the problem solved. And everyone obviously knows how dumb that is. And then I also cited to you guys that, look, there are his neocon positions on being very hawkish on war with Iran have led to people like Paul Joseph Twatson and Mark Dice and all those crazies to be against him. And his own video where he's promoting being hawkish against Iran got, like, you know, a dislike bombed by his own fans. All of those things compacted together, all of those things I just mentioned to you compacted together, have really taken a hit on Ben Shapiro. Seriously, they really have. So for a long time, Ben Shapiro was this guy who on YouTube, there's just video after video of Ben Shapiro destroys feminists or whatever, you know, cringy stuff like that. That has changed. In addition to all that, I showed you guys the view counts and like to dislike ratios of both Kyle Kulinski and Cody Johnson's videos, which had insane like to dislike ratios, as well as over 500,000 views each of those videos. And one of them had like 40,000 likes, the other one had like 32. So the tide is shifting. Now, the one thing I forgot to mention, because I had already thought this a couple days before, but I forgot to mention in the video, Ben Shapiro's career could effectively be over if this thing were to happen, okay? So, he's already taken a lot of hits. Now, anytime someone brings up Ben Shapiro, all you got to do is mention the BBC interview about the homes going underwater stuff, the Iran stuff, and you've already bolted that motherfucker really hard down, really hard, and you've really taken him down a notch pretty heavily at that. Now, Politicon is on October 28th or something like that. So we're about like 3.5 months out. Now, that one's in Nashville. Now, recall that Ben Shapiro did bitch out. He did pussy out from debating Kyle Kulinski. In fact, he didn't debate anybody. He actually didn't debate anybody at Politicon. The supposed debate king didn't debate anybody. But if he is to debate Kyle Kulinski, David Pakman, or Sam Cedar, and he was to be, you know, thoroughly defeated, or even like a good amount defeated, but if, let's say, it was just like a unironic destruction, I don't like to use that word unironically, but let's just use it for that, this hypothetical, I think that he will effectively be erased from having any sort of weight in a conversation, okay? So what I mean by that is this image of Ben Shapiro as being this libtard crusher would be demolished into little pieces. Because anytime someone were to bring him up, you'd mention all of the three things that I just mentioned earlier, as well as in this case, this would be getting destroyed by, you know, one of those three guys, Kyle Kulinski, David Pakman, or Sam Cedar. So, now he's still going to have his fan base, of course. It's just not as vocal as it was before. Already, the audience is already taking a hit, guys. It's going backwards. The vocality of his audience is going backwards. They're losing, social, I want to say market share, although it doesn't sound right. Social capital is what I meant to say. And they're not as strong as they used to be. Guys, there didn't used to be videos against Ben Shapiro with 40,000 likes and 2,000 dislikes. Now Cody Johnson's video has 630,000 views, and it has 40,000 likes to 2.6K dislikes. You think that could exist back in 2012, 2013, 2014, 2015? Jimmy Dore uploaded a video about Ben Shapiro in like 2016. That video has more likes than dislikes, but there's like 10 or 12,000 dislikes on that video, guys. It's really remarkable to watch this progression and see what's happened. because it's truly remarkable, man. It really truly is, guys. But effectively speaking, Ben Shapiro will have no weight in arguments, and you'll be able to clown him basically off the bat if he were to not bitch out and to have a debate with Kyle Kulinski, David Pakman, or Sam Seder, and if he were to lose handily. So, let me know your thoughts on that down below. I'm